So, in the sequence of derivation of Maxwell's equations in differential form, now we are coming to the fourth equation. The total current I enclosed by any path having current density J vector through the surface S is given by I is equal to closed integration over surface S J vector dot ds vector. Equation number 1. According to Ampere's circuital law, closed integration B vector dot dl vector is equal to mu naught I is equal to mu naught closed integration J vector dot ds vector. Equation number 2. On applying Stokes' theorem in LHS, integration closed over surface S curl B vector dot ds vector is equal to mu naught closed integration over S J vector dot ds vector, or closed integration curl B vector minus mu naught J vector dot ds. Equation number 3. Since surface S is arbitrary, therefore curl B vector minus mu naught J vector is equal to 0, or curl B vector is equal to mu naught J. Equation number 4. To check equation number 4, for time varying fields, we suppose charge density rho such that del rho upon del t is not equal to 0. The equation of continuity for time varying fields is divergence J vector plus del rho upon del t is equal to 0, or divergence J vector is equal to minus del rho upon del t. That is, divergence J vector not equal to 0. From equation number 4, J vector is equal to 1 upon mu naught curl B. Taking divergence in both sides, we get divergence J vector is equal to divergence 1 upon mu naught curl B, or equal to 1 upon mu naught divergence curl B, which is 0. We know that divergence of curl of any vector is equal to 0, or divergence J is equal to 0. So these are two very important equations. Here divergence J not equal to 0 in 6, and here divergence J is equal to 0, equation number 7. So from these equations 6 and 7, it is clear that equation number 4 is not valid for time varying fields. According to concept of Maxwell's displacement current, a changing electric field is equivalent to a current called displacement current. Maxwell included the term curl B vector is equal to mu naught epsilon naught del E vector upon del t. Hence, the equation number 4 becomes curl B vector is equal to mu naught J vector plus mu naught epsilon naught del E upon del t. That is, curl B vector is equal to mu naught J vector plus epsilon naught del E upon del t. Equation number 9. So we are taking another form of this equation, number 9, which is again equation 4 of the Maxwell. From equation number 9, 1 upon mu naught curl B is equal to J vector plus del D upon del T, since D is equal to epsilon naught E, or curl B vector upon mu naught is equal to J vector plus del D vector upon del T, or curl H is equal to J plus del D upon del T. This is again very important equation, fourth equation. For free space, the current density J vector is equal to 0. Then fourth equation will be curl H vector is equal to del D upon del T. Thank you so much.